Good afternoon. And welcome to St. Jude the Apostle Parish as we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Lent. Envelopes for the World's Poor Collection are at the entrances of the church. You can start bringing the envelopes back next weekend and place them in the regular collection. Throughout history, humans have had a tendency to choose what is easier, but not necessarily the better path. The easier path often leads away from God and into the darkness of sin. Christ's way is the way of light. We are called to be his disciples, to let go of preferences and actions which keep us in the dark, and to take the path which leads to truth and goodness. Please rise as we celebrate in sacred silence.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves for this most holy Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins. As a sign of our repentance, let us kneel and ask God's pardon and mercy.
To save us from the darkness of sin.
Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie Christe.
Christ Jesus, you were lifted up on the cross and opened the gates of heaven for your faithful people.
Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie Christe.
Lord Jesus, you are the way that leads to eternal life.
Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie Christe.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Please rise. Let us pray. O God, who through your word reconciled the human race to yourself in a wonderful way, grant, we pray, that with prompt devotion and eager faith, the Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. In those days, all the princes of Judah, the priests and the people, added infidelity to infidelity, practicing all the abominations of the nations and polluting the Lord's temple, which he had consecrated in Jerusalem. Early and often did the Lord, the God of our fathers, send his messengers to them, for he had compassion on his people and his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of God, despised his warnings, and scoffed at his prophets, until the anger of the Lord against his people was so inflamed that there was no remedy. Their enemies burnt the house of God, tore down the walls of Jerusalem, set all of its palaces afire, and destroyed all its precious objects. Those who escaped the sword were carried captive to Babylon, where they became servants of the king of the Chaldeans and his sons until the kingdom of the Persians came to power. All this was to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah. Until the land has retrieved its lost Sabbaths, during all the time it lies waste, it shall have rest until 70 years are fulfilled. In the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah, the Lord inspired King Cyrus of Persia to issue this proclamation throughout his kingdom, both by word of mouth and in writing. Thus says Cyrus, king of Persia, all the kingdoms of the earth, the Lord, the God of heaven, has given to me, and he has also charged me to build him a house in Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Whoever, therefore, among you belongs to any part of his people, let him go up, and may his God be with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, God, who is rich in mercy, because of the great love he had for us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, brought us to life with Christ. By grace you have been saved, raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you, it is the gift of God. It is not from works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus, for the good works that God has prepared in advance, that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to you, O Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. Glory to you, O Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. Glory to you,
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, "Just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people preferred darkness to light, because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come toward the light, so that his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is Laudate Sunday, the fourth Sunday of Lent, and if you're wondering why I'm wearing purple and Father has on pink.
Rose!
He said until I learned how to roll my R's, I wasn't getting one of those pink ones.
I can't teach my deacon right.
We have heard many times throughout our lives and from Scripture, "For God so loved the world." But do we really understand how much God loves us? Do we really trust him? If we are a teenager who is overwhelmed because we live in that strange land between childhood and adulthood, and we are trying to cope with everyone's expectations, the expectations of our teachers that we should be a much better student, the expectations of our coaches that we should be a better player, the expectations of our friends that we should be more popular. Do we have the faith to pray, Lord, it's me, Joe, or it's me, Jane, help me deal with this in my life? Are we the businessman who sits with his head in his hands because it's been a terrible year? We had to lay off some people from our small business because the work just wasn't there. We tried to do all that we could to keep them on the payroll, but we just couldn't make the numbers work. And although we know it was the necessary thing to do, we now feel like the worst person in the world. And as we sit and clear our mind, do we really have the faith to say, Lord, it's me, Sam, help me keep this thing together? Are we the woman trying to pray, but as we say the words, our mind is somewhere else? We are thinking about yet another confrontation with our daughter, or about the sure signs of our own mother's growing dementia, or about what we can do with the growing gulf between us and our husband. Do we have the faith in God to say in our own words, Lord, it's me, Megan. I don't know whether I have the strength to go on. We all have burdens to carry, and some of them are very difficult. We get stuck in things we can't change about ourselves, about our work, about our families. And it's when we have to deal with these burdens that we need to know above all else that God is real and that there is someone we can turn to no matter what. But sadly, we don't always do that. Maybe the reason we don't is because somehow we feel that we just don't measure up enough for God to love us. Because we stumble in our efforts to be who God made us to be. And deep down in our souls, we do lack faith. We have doubts. If this happens to be where we find ourselves in our faith journey, take comfort in knowing that Jesus knows us well. He understands our human struggles. He is not looking for you or I to be perfect or to come to him with perfect faith. He wants us to just come, even with our brokenness, even when our faith is shaky at best. And when we think we can't go on, he says, turn to me, and I will give you rest. Trust me, and carry on. That is, he is saying, keep trying. There are many great prayers that we can find in Scripture that can help us in our struggle with doubt. But I think one of the best is when a man came to Jesus and asked him to rescue his son. He said, if you can do anything, take pity on us and help. Jesus said in reply, if you can, everything is possible for the one who believes. The boy's father said, I believe. Help me overcome my unbelief. That's an honest prayer, and Jesus loves honest prayer. The most moving truth that the church tells us is that we are forever loved by God. That he reaches down into our bruised and our hurt world in the person of his son Jesus. No passage in Scripture puts it better than the words which Jesus spoke to Nicodemus. God so loved the world that he sent his only son, so that whoever believes in him may not die, but have eternal rest, eternal life. Our love for others comes nowhere near the kind of love that God has for us. He offers life to all and excludes no one. God's love for us is there, even if we were the only person. We can begin to realize that love for us each time we look upon a crucifix and think about what he suffered for us. And know, even in our brokenness, God loves us. It is easy to be disappointed in the world, in our lives, and especially in ourselves. We have a choice, though. We can wallow in our grief, or we can take a huge step of faith and ask God to make sense out of what appears to be nonsense. We let him take control. When we are convinced we can't handle things ourselves and ask God for help, that's when we are at our strongest. Today, may we pray that we might have the humility and the courage to trust God, to be our strength no matter what, to accept each moment as it comes to us with faith and trust. And along with God, we can find strength to deal with our struggles and doubts by hanging together in our parish community, where along with others, we accept the very human role of being less than perfect followers of Jesus in search of the truth. And we get to rub elbows with people of faith who, after all their own troubles and doubt, still look to Jesus and pray that honest prayer, "I believe, help my unbelief."
Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As we commit ourselves to continual conversion to Jesus, the light of the world, let us offer our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For the leaders of the Church, may Christ, the source of their wisdom, strengthen their hearts as they teach God's law in our world. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For national and local leaders, may God strengthen them in honor and integrity. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the suffering, and those who are living in the darkness of fear, may God bring them the light of his healing and peace. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God help us live our faith more abundantly in order to bear good fruit for him. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died this past week, especially Pat Model, and for those who are mourning the loss of someone dear to them, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the needs within our prayer boxes, the needs expressed through the prayer chain, and for those held within the silence of our hearts. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intention of this Mass, including those for the members of St. Jude Parish, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please join me in praying the prayer to good Saint Joseph that's found in your order of worship. Good Saint Joseph, as you led the Holy Family, watch over our families. Help our family and families to know and share God's love. In our family relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our bishop, and our priest. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of God, the Church. With Mary, you raised Jesus the High Priest. You know our need for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren hear and say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did. Good Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Our preparation song is In Your Worship Aid, Tree of Life.
My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We place before you with these joyful offerings, Lord, which bring eternal remedy, praying that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting for the salvation of all the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, David our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the risen Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
God. Behold, him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Our communion song is "We Remember."
See you. are yearning just to touch you and me. Gather all your people and hold them in your heart. We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we believe that we will see you when you come in your glory, Lord. We remember, we celebrate, we believe. Now we recreate your love, we bring the bread and wine to share a meal, sign of grace and mercy, the presence of the Lord. We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we believe that we will see you when you come in your glory, Lord. We remember, we celebrate, we believe. Christ the Father's great amen to all the hopes and dreams of every heart. Peace be unfailing and freedom from all fear. We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we believe that we will see you when you come in your glory, Lord. We remember, we celebrate, we believe. See the face of Christ revealed in every person standing by your side. Give to one another the temples of your love. We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we believe that we will see you when you come in your glory, Lord. We remember, we celebrate, we believe.
First off, thank you for your presence to participate in this most holy Eucharist. You have no idea how joyful I am at this time to see more and more of you feeling confident to be back in the church. For the past 3 weekends, we are seeing more and more of you are coming back feeling safe and confident to be part of the community and this celebrating community. Just so that you know, that church is a safe place. All the safety protocols we are still continuing to follow. But at the same time, we also rely on our faith. And that's what we have on our wristband. Keep me safe, O Lord, for I take refuge in you. When we enter the house of the Lord, we are taking refuge in the Lord. Thank you for your presence, and let us continue to fill our pews and be together as a faith community in worshiping and glorifying the Lord. Thank you again. The announcements. The monthly lunchtime concert is this Wednesday, March 17th, St. Patrick's Day, at 12:30 p.m. at Sacred Heart Church. You are invited to join the Irish theme concert in person or watch live on our Facebook page or watch it on our YouTube channel. This Friday, March 19, is the Solemnity of St. Joseph. You are invited to a special 7:30 a.m. Mass at Sacred Heart Church, followed by consecration to St. Joseph after the Mass. And to continue the celebration of the Feast of St. Joseph and to follow his example of his care for the poor, you are invited to bring loaves of bread to any of the next weekend masses for a traditional blessing of St. Joseph as the provider of the Holy Family. This St. Joseph bread can be used to share within the family and can be shared with the poor in honor of St. Joseph as an act of mercy during Lent. So I really and highly encourage all of you to bring bread for the blessing so that we can share with the members of the family and with those in need. Thank you and God bless you. Let us pray. O God, who enlighten everyone who comes into this role, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty and love you in all sincerity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. Look upon those who call to you, O Lord, and sustain the weak. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death, and bring those rescued by your mercy from every evil to reach the highest good. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our sending forth song is The Church is One Foundation.
Christ our Lord, she is His mother. Church, man.